So this is my MacBook and it's now quite old, and with time its performance has been decreased a lot and it is heating a lot. So I decided to change its thermal paste and see if any good happens to the performance of this laptop. So in this video I'll be showing you how to change thermal paste on the MacBook's 2016-2017 MacBook Pro with touch bar, without touch bar, any MacBook. So firstly I'll be showing you the before and after performance of this laptop so that you can decide whether you should go for changing the thermal paste or not. So I'll be exporting a Final Cut Pro file. So this is the file and I'll export it. So I actually got late over here to start stopwatch on my iPhone, so I'll add the 77 seconds delay later in the results. So now let's see how much time will it take. Now you can see the temperatures and the some data of the CPU and related things. If you want to check, you can see. And if we say about the external temperature, it's around 61, and the fan is around 6500 RPM. It's huge. It's on auto currently. Then also it's so high. That is the main reason I want to change the thermal paste. So the total time here is 13 minutes 52 seconds which took to export, including the 77 seconds which we added. So now we have jumped into the future where we have changed the thermal paste of the MacBook, and we'll see if we have gained any performance over here. And as you can see, the external temperature currently is around 50 degrees Celsius, and notably the fan speeds are down to 3500-4000 range currently. Now it's been 6 minutes and the fan speed is around 5000 RPM, which is still less than the last values. And talking about the CPU temperatures, you can see over there in the fan control. And if I touch the laptop, yeah, it's quite hot even now, but it's not like which was earlier. But the relative temperature change, the Dell temperature, can be actually measured by the heat gun only. But actually I am seeing more temperature over here than the last one. You can see it's touching 63 65, but the temperature is more, but you can see the significant performance gain over here. The file got exported up to 36% faster. I saved around 4 minutes 47 seconds. It's really humongous, such a big change. I want to add here one thing, that I don't know why the temperature of MacBook was showing so high while I was rendering the video earlier after changing the thermal paste, because while I have edited this whole video of 30 minutes, the MacBook was not at all lagging at all, and the temperature was quite warm, I should say, but it was not that hot which earlier it used to get. So now let's start the servicing of our laptop. Please perform it at your own risk. I'll not be responsible for any damage you do to your laptop. So before starting, I will suggest you to put on a cover like this shown in the video, so that you can save your MacBook from scratches, as we will be servicing it upside down and it can scratch with the table. So it's better to have a protection over here. Now I'll be using isopropyl alcohol, which is 99.9% pure. So you have to get this one only, because it has very less water, only 0.1% water. So now I will clean the MacBook from the display and the keys, because there can be dust and smaller particles over here, and if we pressurize when screwing or unscrewing, they can damage the screen. So I'll be actually saying that you should do this. Now you can even keep a cloth beneath the MacBook while servicing. I have actually mask taped the serial number. Now you will be requiring this type of screwdriver. So this is the screwdriver, and the bits of the screwdriver is on the opposite side. You will be also be requiring a suction cup like this one, and a plastic plier type of thing. This is also required, this one particularly, you require this. Now talking about the screwdrivers, which you need is 1.2 pentalobe screws, T2, T3 and T4. These are the screwdriver bits which you need for this repair. So now let's start. So I'll be actually taking the 1.2 pentalobe screw bit and applying it to my screwdriver head. This particular screwdriver bit is used to open the casing of the MacBook. Also, I am having this type of magnetic pad over here. It's quite small. I will recommend you to buy a bigger one. It is very handy, else you can lose your screws. So now I'll start unscrewing the screws. There are a total of 6 screws on the bottom of the MacBook. So here I am unscrewing it. I will fast forward the video because this is a very non-technical part of the video. So I'll unscrew all, and as you can see, I'm keeping them on the one side of the magnetic pad so that I know these screws were from the casing. So now this tool will be very handy in the whole process, as it will help in opening the laptop also and actually removing wires inside also. So now what we'll do is we'll use this suction cup and place it over here like this. And now when we'll pull it, there will be a little bit of gap shown, like it's a gap of 1 mm will be there, as you can see this much gap. So now put this pry tool under the gap and perform like what I am showing. So I'll put it over here and slide it towards the center of the MacBook, and when I'll reach the center, I will pressurize it towards up so that there is a clip over there which will open. There will be a huge click sound, don't be scared from that. Similarly, do it on the other side. I will again apply the suction cup and perform the same thing until I listen to a click sound. So here the both ends are free, the two clips are now opened. So now what you'll notice is that the cover of the MacBook can be lifted away much higher than before, like this. So now to show you, it can now open up to 1 centimeter or so, 2 centimeter maybe, or maybe I think even 1 inch. Yes, even 1 inch. So you can open it up to this point. So you can actually firmly grip it over here, and you have to then pull it outwards like I am doing. The same thing you have to do. When you will do this and use the other hand to push it from beneath, so this will eventually open the casing. So this is how our MacBook looks from inside, and this is the casing. It's quite dirty, you can see dust all over here and there. If I show you from a bit closer, there's a lot of dust over here which will clean. You can get the idea of the mechanism of working of this case. These are the two stationary clips and these are the moving clips. So you first actually pull it over the stationary and then you pull downwards to disengage the moving clips which are located over here. So this is the mechanism. It is very easy, you can see, and once you'll see it with your own eyes, you know then how to remove it and to put it back for the next time. So this is the amount of dust you can see offered on this laptop inside, and it's quite huge, but I was expecting even more because the MacBook was heating a lot, but then also it's much. So now I'll be using this anti-static brush over here. So now this is not recommended to use currently, you should not use it, but there was a lot of dust, so I removed it. But I'll recommend you not to do this. First, you should always remove battery from your laptop. You should remove the battery so that you don't short anything. Even if a single component is shorted, it can lead to huge bills. So here I cleaned it a little bit, and I think it's not that clean, but yeah, it's now workable. So now after cleaning it, I made a huge mistake. It was such a big mistake that I could have bricked my whole laptop. So what I did was, I thought that this wire which was of trackpad was of battery, and I thought that I have removed the battery wire, but it was actually of the trackpad. And in the whole process of removing wires and removing the motherboard and every components from the motherboard, the battery was actually attached to the laptop. But to my surprise, the laptop wasn't damaged and every function is currently working. So thanks to Apple for some weird security which it has given, that the battery didn't short anything. So you can now learn from my mistakes and don't do the same. So for removing the battery, firstly we have to remove this wire. Now removing such cables have a similar mechanism in the whole laptop. There are many cables and they are mostly with the same mechanism. What you have to do is, you have to lift this type of buckle over here, and after that when you lift it, the clip opens and you can now just take away the wire off of it. So this wire is now removed. So now I'll be showing you the correct way only. So I'll be jumping to the future when I was removing the motherboard and I removed the battery at that point. So I'll show you which point is of battery and you have to remove it at first. So in the MacBook, this point right here is the battery point. This is the terminal of the battery. So you have to remove it the first. You have to unscrew it, and as soon as you unscrew it, just take off it in once, because there is a positive and negative terminal point over here, and if it shorts with anything, it can break the whole laptop. So when you actually open it and set it aside, set it such that it doesn't touch anything. After that, you can remove this trackpad over here. So while I was making the video, I was thinking that this is only the battery. And after removing that, I was very casual in handling the laptop. I even used some sprays and all, and I was like that if a battery is disconnected, I cannot damage anything. So this is the trackpad wire, and I disconnected it like this. You have to just pull it upwards and it will disconnect just like this. So because I was thinking that this wire is of the battery, so I thought that I should cover it up. And I tried to use this type of suction cup, but it was not working. So I actually used a suction cup and made suction just ahead of it so that it doesn't come forward. I did this just because I thought this is the main wire of battery. But I was unaware that the main battery wire is that one. And I actually knew that, but at the time I was making the video, I just forgot that. I don't know why this happened. Now I even used this inert gas spray. Now I don't know if it is actually the inert gas or not. But I used that. So the spray helps to remove much of the dirt. Now while spraying the fans, you should hold them like this so that they won't spin freely, as spinning freely can damage them. Now after that, you will start removing the connections from the motherboard. So you'll use the T3 screw and unscrew all these screws like this. And now you have to unplug this first bracket. There are many brackets, so you have to unplug all the brackets on the motherboard like I am showing. So when you unplug a bracket, keep it on the magnetic pad and also the screws with it only, so that when you'll, you apply the bracket back, you know that these screws were from them. So now currently with the all screws which I am showing are being opened with the T3 screwdriver only. Now I opened this bracket. This bracket is particularly of the fan over here. And now I am opening this bracket over here, and I'll also unplug it just like this by pulling it upwards. Now use plastic pryer only. If you will use metallic, it will short, and in my case, if I would have used, it would have definitely shorted because the battery was connected. Now I'm even using my hand freely, and hand is also conductive. It could have shortened something, but to my surprise, actually I was safe. Now I'm removing this wire, but actually it was quite difficult to remove because of the less space. So I have to use this type of plier to remove it. So here I go to remove it, and I removed it easily. Similarly, I will do for the other. Over here there are Wi-Fi antennas and all, and I will displug them using the same pryer. So these wires are now disconnected. After that, there are some wires over here also. In the same manner, we will unplug them. So there are these two wires. One is even below it, so you have to disconnect both. But I was not able to disconnect the below one, as it was quite fragile, and it was looking if I pull it, it will break. So I left it off for now, and I'll actually remove it when the motherboard will be free to come up. After that, there are some screws over here and some brackets which will be removing. Now keep in mind that every screw which you are removing and every bracket, keep them very systematically on the magnetic pad. In my case, the magnetic pad was quite small, but I managed to use it. But I will suggest you to always take a big magnetic pad so that there is no confusion of which screw is where. So now while I was trying to remove this bracket, I saw that this screw was not coming off because the top of the screw was corroded or something, that it was a factory issue, that the screw was not just coming off, the T3 screwdriver was not going in. So I used some super glue to bond the T3 screwdriver bit with it, and then actually twisted it, and it came off. After that, I took away these wires which were beneath it, and now I was searching for some more wires, and I found this one. So we have to unplug the bracket, keep it aside with the screws so that we don't lose our screws. So here it comes off. Now I'll take off the bracket also, and below it is the wire, so we'll unplug it. So this wire is also unplugged right here. After that, I was in search of more wires and found one this over here. So now this was also one of a typical wire because it was in a tight spot. I opened the clip, but I was not able to actually pull it off at the moment. But I tried and tried, but I was not successful. So there was a screw over here also, a bracket type of thing. So I removed it, and there it was a wire. So I removed it like this and plugged it. And now all the wires were disconnected. Now there are screws on the motherboard which keep it in place. We'll remove all these screws. Now the bottom three screws below the fans are the T3 screws, and above it are the T4s. So which are being removed by me just now are the T3 screws. And now I have changed to the T4 bit. The screws which I am removing now are the T4 bits. So now whenever you are removing or placing a screw, screwdriver or and removing the screw, place it very gently and try to twist it. And if it twists, then only continue. Otherwise, you will know that you are using the wrong bit. Don't just go and apply pressure from the starting only. So now all the screws are removed, as you can see. I have also removed these fan screws over here. Like you are seeing, I have removed them. So all screws are unscrewed now. And but I am trying to lift the MacBook's motherboard, and it's not lifting. I saw this screw over here also. When all the screws will be out and all the cables will be disconnected, the motherboard comes off very easily without any pressure. But then also it was not coming. So I saw that. So firstly, I decided to take off this wire, which I didn't take off earlier. Because now I was able to lift the motherboard, so it was easy for me to take off it. So now I also take off this rubber gaskets which were over the fan from the both sides. After that, I saw that the display cable was actually not letting the motherboard come off. So there was a bracket over it. I unscrewed it and I popped off the display wire from over here. The clip in which I opened the display bracket was not available. I think it got deleted or I didn't record that, but it's over here only. You have to remove these brackets. There are two brackets which are placing the display bracket, and you have to remove them and unplug the display wire. So now this was the point when I realized that I have not unplugged the battery, so I unplugged it just right now. And after that, I saw this cable on the top left which was not unplugged, so I unplugged it. Now the motherboard can be lifted very easily without any pressure. It's coming out, and I want to see ensure that no cable gets teared off while removing the motherboard, and here I get successful in that. And you can see finally the motherboard is out, and it's so good to see that such a small board can perform such well. So now I use pressurized gas to set off the residual dust from the MacBook. So now I was actually spinning the fan with the air, which is not recommended, but I am doing it because much of dust was removing. So now my fans were not that dirty, but if yours are, you can remove the fan and open them and clean them also. But I don't think that I was having the requirement for that. So now this is the motherboard. We will flip it upside down, and we can see the screws right over here. So now we have to remove these screws in a pattern, such that we'll first remove the screw, unscrew it to 20%, then we'll unscrew the other screw 20%, which is diagonally opposite to it. Then this one, again 20%, then the diagonally opposite to this one. Let me show you the bit number. Now this one. So we'll be doing this because these brackets which are installed over here are acting as springs. So if we actually remove one screw instantly, then it will pop off very badly and can even break. Also the CPU beneath it can get uneven pressures and can also break. Now even when you will be unscrewing them slowly, then also they'll be showing some spring and action and will pop off like instantly. But when you will be, if you will not follow this, then it will be like firing up. So now I have removed these brackets and have kept them aside, and now I'll flip over and give me a second. So here I flip it over. So this is how it looks. And now I can remove the bracket from over here, this heat sink, which you can say. So I have removed this heat sink and you can see that the thermal paste has gone. It has no life left. And that was the reason that my laptop was working so slow. So you can see this. And it's just not working at all, because since I have bought this laptop, I have not changed it even once, and the MacBook has not even gone for service. So I'm now using the Arctic brand MX4 branded thermal paste over here. So I read the reviews for it and it was quite positive. You can go for any thermal paste, but go for the one which is non-conductive, as if you will go for liquid metal type of thing, you can actually break your laptop, as it can short things up. So now I'll be using the 99.9% pure IPA, which I have showed you in the starting of the video also. Please use the 99.9% one only. As if the IPA is less pure, that means the water level is higher in that, and hence conductivity is more. So here you can see I have used a cotton bud and I have softened the old thermal paste over the CPU, and I'll now be using a cloth to remove that. So here you can see the most of it has been removed using the cloth. And now I'll use a second earbud and performing the same task again and again until I get the clear CPU just as new over here. So now it's not that necessary that you clean that old paste thoroughly, and like if some what is left, then it will harm to your laptop. It's not like that, but I managed to remove that easily, so it was not a problem for me. Now I'll be applying the new thermal paste. You can see this is the new thermal paste. I will apply into a very small quantity. I will apply it what I think is right. Same you have to do. You have to not over apply it, not less apply it. As if you will apply less, then the conductivity will be less. And if you will apply more, the layer will be so thick that the conductivity can reduce. So now I'll use this pry tool only to smudge this all over so that it has a even layer. Now people actually don't do this. They simply just put on the heat sink and it only spreads the thermal paste. But I like to do this way, because then I can ensure yes, I have actually spreaded it rightly. Now if you spread it over the green area, then there's no problem, as you can see that the old paste which was directly original from Apple, that was also on the green area. Now you can see that I am aligning the heat sink in the wrong way. So you don't have to do this. Now when I was doing this, I recorded this clip and not recorded the different clip in which I have fixed this. So you have to apply the heat sink in the different orientation. As you can see, it's currently getting in the different direction. But I just wanted to show over here that you have to even put in the screws with the same technique of screwing in 20%, then 40%, then 50%. Don't screw one screw at a time. So now you can see that I have changed the orientation rightly, and the thermal heat sink is now aligned properly well. So now what we'll be doing is we'll be keeping the motherboard back in position on the MacBook, and we will ensure that no wire comes under it. Now if one or two wires even come under it, you can remove it later on, because we'll not screwing it first. We'll be actually connecting the wires, then only we'll be screwing it. So when the screws will not be on, then you can easily shift, or you can upward lift the motherboard at any point of time to get the underneath cables out, so there that will not be a problem. So firstly I start off by connecting this display wire. So firstly I make the plan over here that I will firstly join all the wires and all, and then only I will start putting on the metal caps over them and putting the screws one at once only. So firstly I'm connecting all the wires, and then further I will be doing the cappings. And over here you can see this wire was quite extremely difficult to put in, so I decided to put in first because at this time I can lift the motherboard and can put it very easily. So here you can see I have put it in very easily over here. Same goes for the other wire which was sticking. Now this I am connecting this wire which was over here. Now this wire was, you know, also very difficult to take out, so I decided to put it back in the first, and I was successful in doing that because the MacBook's motherboard was easy to lift up at that particular point. And likewise I was just putting on the other wires which I was seeing over here. The one wire which I just saw, I just at that prime just putting that back all, because I was actually a little bit frustrated at the moment because I was not clear that will the MacBook boot off or not, because I made that mistake of the battery one. But surprisingly it booted and no problem came. So here now I am putting back the display screws. So the hinge of the display has been screwed by me. Likewise, I am just putting the metal cap over here and screwing it also. So these are very simple steps. Just you have to repeat what you have done in the reverse order. So here is the fan wire holder. So I am also installing it right now, just screwing it. And here I go. Similarly, whichever thing which I am seeing, I am going for it. So it's not like you have to follow the same order. You can go for it like your liking, as per your liking. Like if you see a wire, you can just connect it at any point of time. It's not like you have to connect one first and the second other. So here I am just putting the holders back on with the screws, and this one is the last one, I think so. So here I put it. Oh yeah, this one is left, so I'm also putting this holder over here. You might be looking at it and it will be looking difficult to you, but when you'll be doing it, it's very easy. But the key point of this is that you should keep the connectors and the screws with them so that you don't lose them. You should use a magnetic pad. So now just everything is done. You have to put all the screws of the MacBook's motherboard right back. The T4s on the T4 place and T3s on the T3 place, like I showed you when I was unscrewing the screws. So now I'll be installing the trackpad wire back again. And I have screwed it properly. After that, now I'll go for the battery. So now be careful by plugging the battery. Once you have just put it on the connector, hold it tightly with your finger so that it doesn't move much, and screw it immediately like I have done, because if it will move a lot, it can cause sparks and can damage the motherboard. After that, just connect this cable. Now most part of the repair is done. So earlier I forgot to put on these rubber gaskets of the fans, so I decided to put it right away. Now I could have done that, unscrew 2-3 screws and lift over the motherboard and applied them, but I decided to go like that only because I was not even sure that will my MacBook boot on or not because of the battery issue which I told you earlier. Now we have to just put on the cover back on, and as you can see we'll be screwing the back panel once again. and my MacBook was thankfully working very well, and it was 36% better than before, as I showed you in the starting of the video. So that was the whole video. Thanks for watching my video. I hope it helped you. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel if you enjoyed watching this video. Peace.